this little button machine is the 8BitDo Micro. And more than just a compact gamepad and a cute fashion accessory, it's also a versatile shortcut remote for digital art on PC and mobile devices. Yes, that includes Procreate on the iPad. Let's draw some stuff and see how it works. Hey, Ryan here. So as you know, I'm a big fan of the Tourbox for my digital art shortcuts, but for many people, that's a little bit over budget, especially if you're looking for mobile compatibility. The 8BitDo Micro, on the other hand, is affordable at only $25 and will work with your PC, your Switch, your Galaxy Tab, or an iPad. Of course, you can use it for gaming, but we're going to be focusing on how to use this little gamepad as a shortcut remote for digital drawing and painting software. Before we get to that though, inside the box you get the controller, a little lanyard, the instruction manual, and the shortest USB cable I have ever seen. Probably won't be using that. But anyway, taking a closer look at the controller, the 8BitDo has a total of 16 buttons on it, and they're nicely grouped both in shape and placement. They have different feels to them, quite unlike regular shortcut remotes, but very typical of gaming controllers. There's the D-pad, these action buttons, triggers on the front, the start, select, home, and little logo button. On the bottom here, we have a switch for modes and also a Bluetooth pairing button. And around the back, we have a USB-C port for charging. I typically hold it like this with the round buttons at the top and the D-pad at the bottom, because then I can still hit these along the side a bit more comfortably. It weighs only 25 grams and is, what, let's see, a mere 7 by 4 by 1.5 centimeters. And next to the much heavier Tourbox and the Huion Keydial Mini, which is also iPad compatible, this is really tiny. Throw it in your pocket and you're good to go. You can use it wired or with Bluetooth, and I haven't tested this specifically, but it's expected to have around 10 hours of playtime, which is plenty. The setup is pretty easy. First, you'll need to download the 8BitDo Ultimate software onto your mobile device. You can't program this on computer, so you will need either your phone or, in this case, the iPad. Then pair your device by turning it on with this button, and then pairing with this one on the bottom. You must be in K mode for keyboard in order to program it. Once you're paired, the micro will appear, and then it's time to customize. You'll land on the presets page where you can create different profiles for the apps that you want to use, and then set shortcuts for each. Once your buttons are set, or when you want to change profiles, you'll have to sync that to the controller. It won't change automatically when you're changing applications. To show you in a bit more detail, I've created a dedicated profile for Magma here. Then switching to the buttons page, you can assign individual keys and combos to your buttons. I've gone and done all of this already and grouped the buttons like this. The top action buttons are for tools, blend, brush, eraser, and eyedropper. The D-pad is for tool parameters, specifically size and opacity. These four handle layer stuff, and then the buttons on the side or the front are for other things like undo and switching to grayscale mode or resetting my viewport. Something that is missing and I'd like to see in a future update is perhaps being able to assign buttons to mouse clicks. Now, what about using this with Procreate? This is obviously a well-designed mobile app where, aside from pen input, you're going to be navigating a lot with touch to change between different tools, adjust settings, that kind of thing. But there are also keyboard shortcuts for those who prefer it. But how to find the shortcuts in the first place? For that, we need this, the command key. But instead of using a wireless keyboard for that, I've just programmed this into the controller. But you'll notice that there is no command key listed in any of the button tabs. Instead, you have to use the Windows key in place of command, and you're going to need this for quite a few shortcuts. Press and hold the Windows assigned button in Procreate to bring up the available shortcuts and note down what you want to use. Rather than diving deeper into Procreate here, I suggest checking out Moss Charmley Presents video. They've got a really nice detailed tutorial on this. Now let's get to painting, shall we? I'm going to be using Magma for this on the iPad. First, is everything working? Brush size increases and decreases. Switching between the brush, eraser, and blend is all working. Good, good. Cool, let's go. But now, what to paint? Okay, I know. Unfortunately, the 8BitDo Micro only comes in two colors, blue and green. I don't have what I need with me currently to customize this myself, so instead I'm just going to draw a red one in Magma to match my Magma Red PS4 controller. I've been loving the recent traditional still life paintings that Dawn Carlos has been posting on Instagram, so I kind of want to go in that direction with this. Something I really like here is that the shortcuts are all synced to the device. So I work in Magma most of the time and across different devices. And when I want to switch over, all I have to do is reestablish Bluetooth connection with whatever I'm using, and the same shortcuts are there ready to go. I don't need to reprogram or switch profiles or anything like that. I did bump this bottom trigger a bit while I was using it, so I reset my view by accident a couple of times, but that's not a big deal. I mentioned earlier how the buttons of this have shapes and placement that is different to regular shortcut remotes, so I want to bring a few out to show you a bit more of what I mean. I've got one from XP Pen here, and the Huion key dial. These are nice in that they have the dial to work with, but the buttons are quite similar to each other. The Key Dial Mini in particular has a whole lot of these same feel buttons. Gaming controllers, on the other hand, have more unique layouts and button feels, which makes it easier to build up muscle memory, which is pretty important for gaming. This is something that Tourbox took note of and implemented in their devices too, and I love these. So with the Micro, you definitely feel the difference in buttons under your fingers. And even though this is quite small, it was still pretty easy to hit exactly the buttons that I wanted. It doesn't take all that long to get used to, and once you do, I have to say, this actually works really well, and it covers a lot of what I need. So there you have it, the 8BitDo Micro. Really cool, versatile little device. Ideal if you draw on your phone or a tablet. 8BitDo put on their product page, micro but capable, and I think that is a spot on description. It was really easy to set up and use, and it did a great job for what I needed it to. And also, quite importantly, it's only $25, so it's a really affordable and handy addition to your setup, no matter what device you're using. So something like the Tourbox Elite Plus is a whole lot more than you want to spend, then why not check this out? I've got a written review of this, as well as what I've programmed each button to do in Magma, listed down below in the description, as well as how to use a PlayStation 4 controller on PC as a shortcut remote. Now I'm going to get back to some painting, or maybe I'll play a little game first. Ciao for now!